We've heard a great deal in the news lately about some new and unusual illnesses spreading the globe. Alison Tucker, epidemiologist from the Division of Public Health, will tell us how these emerging diseases are tracked here in St. Charles County. Alison, welcome back to Safe and Sound.
Thanks for having me.
So how does St. Charles County staff work with medical providers from both our region, from the state, and also from the federal government to track emerging diseases?
There are several ways that we track diseases. One of those, when you have illnesses such as flu or salmonella, those are considered reportable conditions. So medical providers, laboratories are required to report those conditions to us. So when we get those, we investigate them, we log them, and we track them over time. We can look at those at the local level, the state level, and even at national level. If we were to have an outbreak of something or even a rare illness that we're not used to seeing and we need some help investigating that, we can call on our state and federal agencies such as the CDC, and then we would all work together to investigate those cases. We also do what's called active disease surveillance. That's where we're really going out and actively trying to see what's going on in our community. So. We have a system called Essence that we use for that. And Essence is a real-time database that looks at chief complaints from emergency departments. So if you were to go to an emergency department, when you give your complaint and they log that into the computer, it automatically goes into our database. It's not looking at your name or your address. All it's doing is allowing public health officials to look at chief complaints, kind of monitor symptoms in the community. It gives us an idea of what's circulating in our community. We also have good relationships with hospitals, urgent care, medical providers, schools, daycares. So if we're seeing something that's circulating and we feel like they need to know, we have the means to reach out to them and ask for information or just give them some information, and they're really good at getting that information back to us too.
Although on a regular basis, your staff predominantly works with common illnesses, we've heard in the news the last couple of weeks about something scary called Ebola. What can you tell me about Ebola?
Ebola is a scary disease. It does have a fairly high death rate, but the thing that works with us when it comes to Ebola is that it's not that contagious. It's not easy to catch Ebola. You have to have direct contact with someone who is ill with Ebola. You have to have direct contact with their bodily fluids. Even amongst households, if you have a patient there, only 1 in 6 become ill, if that kind of puts it in perspective a little bit. So Ebola can be easily controlled with isolation and quarantine. Isolating the patient who is sick and then monitoring and quarantining all contacts to that patient so that if they do develop symptoms, we can get them to a hospital and limit their number of contacts. Right now in the United States, we monitor all travelers that are coming back from affected countries in West Africa so that we have those control measures in place. So for the general public, there's not a real risk of contracting Ebola, but I think it is important to know what it is and how important it is to control it in the countries that are seeing it.
It's really nice to know that the likelihood of someone getting something that drastic is pretty low. But there are chances for people to get common diseases and common illnesses. What are some things that people can do to prevent just illness in general, I guess?
I cannot stress hand washing enough. Hand washing, soap, water. Most of the illness we get are from picking up germs, viruses, bacteria on our hands and then touching our face. So if we're regularly washing our hands with soap and water, you really reduce that risk. If soap and water is not available, hand sanitizers will also work. And especially this time of year with flu season, we're in the middle of flu season, it's important to know that you can get the flu shot to protect yourself and your family members, and it's not too late to get that flu shot.
Where could somebody get some more information about what your staff does?
You can call our health department at any time. Our number is 636-949-7400, or you can visit our website.
Thanks so much, Alison. It's reassuring to know that people are working to help keep us safe. Thank you.
Thank you.